In the late 1950s, Porsche developed the 718 RSK, a two-seater sports car to enter Formula 2. And yes, the rules permitted this back in the day. In 1968, they decided to modify these cars by moving the seat in the middle and entered the Formula 1 championship. They soon realized that these cars were not competitive. So for the next season, they developed the flat-8 powered 804. This new car would go on to win the 1962 French Grand Prix at the hands of Dan Gurney. At the end of the season, they decided to quit F1 due to the high cost. Having success in the 70s with their turbocharged engines, Porsche returned to F1 in 1983, where they supplied McLaren with water-cooled V6 turbo engines. The flat engines were out because they would be too wide and disturb the aerodynamics. So TAG and Porsche co-developed the 90-degree V6. At first, the bosses over at Porsche were reluctant to have their badges on the engine. The engines powered McLaren to 25 victories between 1984 and 1987, 19 of which were for Alan Prost and 6 for Niki Lauda. Porsche returned to F1 again in 1991 as an engine supplier, however this time with disastrous results. The footwork Arrows cars powered with the overweight Porsche 3512 double V6, which weighed 400 pounds or 180 kilograms. The engine was in fact two combined TAG V6 engines used by McLaren from 1983 to 1987, minus the turbochargers. They failed to score a single point and failed even to qualify for over half the races that year. Porsche has not participated in Formula 1 since, but they'll soon be back in 2026 and might find a partner with Red Bull.